Good day everyone, welcome back to my channel. To this video, I'm going to share you 5 easy steps on how to become a real estate agent. So, as we know that becoming a real estate agent is a great deal. Why? Because you encounter different clients every day, different people, so and also different projects if you are into a freelance real estate. So first and foremost, before you are going to start as a real estate agent, you have to look first for a fit or a proper requirements on how to become a real estate agent. So what is the basic requirements to become a real estate agent? At least you are a college or 2-year course graduate and has 72 units. So that is the very basic requirements of becoming a real estate. So the second step, at least you know a broker, a real estate broker, or if you don't know any real estate broker, you can look for a real estate developer. So who are those real estate developers? Real estate developers are those like companies who are engaging into developing a property, a real estate properties, like they're developing condominiums, houses, subdivisions, and offices. So who are those companies here in the Philippines? Commonly, their name is like Ayala Land, PhilInvest. So those are common names of as a real estate developer. So the third way on how you're gonna engage into a real estate agent is look for a real estate services firm. So those who are engaged in real estate services like selling, so they are hiring real estate agents because they also have real estate brokers. So why is it the second step is you're gonna look for these people or you're gonna look for these companies? Because as a real estate agent, you cannot sell a properties without a real estate broker because you're gonna get your affiliation from the real estate broker. So that's why you need those like real estate developer, real estate firm, and real estate broker. So the third step we're gonna go is, at least if you already engage in the company or as a real estate broker, you have at least get a CPD or 15 units CPD. So that is the requirements in getting your PRC and HGLEORB license. At least 15 units CPD, you can take that one as a seminar. The companies or the firm who are involved in those like PAREB, REBAP, and CRA, so those are the firm that involves in giving the certifications and seminars. So of course there are fees regarding that kind of seminars intended for that seminars like 1 to 2 days, but the good thing with that kind of seminars is that they're gonna give you some information regarding real estate, legalities, how was the market, the taxes, and everything. So those are the firm or those are the CPD certifications that you need to get in order you can get the PRC license later or PRC accreditation. So the fourth step that to become a real estate agent is you're gonna get your PRC accreditation and HLURB accreditation. So if you are into selling the projects like developers, that's why you really need a HLURB accreditations. So they're gonna give you also the ID of that, then also the PRC. So without the presence of your real estate broker, you cannot get those accreditations from the PRC and HLURB. The PRC has some requirements like CPD units, the certification, the TOR, so your valid IDs in VA and everything. So these are the recent requirements that they require for you in order to get the affiliation from the PRC and HLURB for becoming a real estate agent. So the last and the 5th steps on how to become a real estate agent, since you already done processing your PRC and HLURB license, so the last one is that you can start selling a projects or properties. If ever you are still new with this industry, make sure that you do have a guidance from your managers or from your brokers so that you will get more projects and listings when it comes to real estate, and you will become updated when it comes to the latest projects. You will know the pricing, how does it works, on how you're gonna engage with the buyers, with the clients, how you're gonna do the services. Because as a real estate agent, you need to know your responsibilities on how you're gonna serve your clients in a righteous way. So that's why you need a guidance from your real estate broker or from the real estate firm that you are applying for. And aside from that, many of the developers or real estate firm, they are giving also some of the trainings regarding on how to become a real estate agent, how to start selling a real estate project. Actually, this is just only a very long way for you to go. And the good thing when it comes to becoming a real estate agent is that it will give you a fortune later, but make sure you have to follow the steps on how to do it legally, because there are some agents that they are not following the process, or they are not doing the due diligence, which is processing their PRC and HLURB license, which is that is against our law when it comes to real estate selling, because the real estate industry is very huge and it acquires or it needs more attention, because the money that the clients are being put there is that it's just not certain centavo or a peso. It requires like a million investment. So I think that's all for today. Thank you for watching, and I'll be sharing you also some of the videos on how to become a real estate agent successfully. Thank you and God bless.